Hello, what's happening? This is my Ender 3 Pro Plus printer. I'm close to sunsetting. This isn't a recommendation for this old printer. God no. This is a video about what grinds my gears the most when I watch other people's videos about 3D printing on YouTube. But let's back off a little bit. So, this is an aging Ender 3 Pro, the Toyota Corolla of 3D printers, if you will. But this printer in its latest form has some upgrades, of both free and paid variety. That's why I call it a plus. Some of the upgrades I no longer use, but most of the free ones, printed by the printer itself, are still with the printer. But by far the most important upgrade I did to this printer is installing Creality's Sear Touch auto-leveling sensor. Adding this sensor utterly transformed this from a decent but sometimes aggravating printer to an absolute banger, capable of printing dimensionally accurate prints almost perfectly and with zero hassle. Truly, that age-old dream of print it and forget it realized. But what's the secret? Because it's not the leveling sensor. Although I find it criminal that Creality didn't bestow it this sensor from the factory. Just as I found it outrageous that Creality, and other manufacturers for sure, still try to sell this generation and style of printers in a time when this kind may as well be made out of stone, wood, and held together with ropes. Creality itself has devastatingly better printers on offer, competing for the same bottom price. So, it's not a sensor. But what is it? It's godliness. Did I say godliness? I meant cleanliness. Absolute cleanliness of the printing bed is the secret ingredient to a happy printing life. The role of the printing bed is twofold: to provide adhesion to the printed model, but also to release said model once the printing is done. Ideally, you want infinite adhesion while printing and zero adhesion after the printing has finished. And we came pretty close after almost 20 years of open source 3D printing and incremental progress in every aspect of it. Of course, the quality of the printing bed doesn't matter much if the printer itself is a mess, if the bed leveling isn't perfect, or the printhead cannot home itself perfectly every time and keep true with the bed, no matter how warped it may be. But I'll have to assume all this is sorted. You spent your money and either got a great printer or arrived at a good one through building smart on a good base. You level the bed and offset the nozzle at the perfect height. The only thing that now stands between you and that every time perfect print is discipline. But back to the printing bed. Its best form is when it's new, and when it's new, it's clean. If you manage to keep it clean and don't abuse its structure and surface, you'll get both that perfect adhesion you're looking for and ease of release of the printed models. These are my rules for keeping a healthy, clean printing bed. Rule number one: never touch the printing surface with bare hands. Treat it like a vinyl record if you have to manipulate it. Of course, I'm talking about the active surface where the printing is done, not the outer perimeter. Grease, dust, glue residue, old plastics, and contaminants of any kind are the enemy when it comes to consistent adhesion and release cycles. It doesn't matter if you don't have that greasy of a hand, or if the fingerprint doesn't show. If you accidentally touch the surface, don't be lazy. Pause the process, grab a cotton pad and a tiny amount of IPA, and wipe down the surface to be sure. If you use other cleaning chemicals, use the ones meant for cleaning glass and without perfume. Those are the least likely to leave unknown contaminants to the surface. Rule number two: don't remove the print by taking the bed out and bending it from under the model. Wait for the bed to cool a little and you should be able to just push it off the bed, again without touching the surface with your hands. I'm a strong opponent of manipulating the spring steel or whatever substrate your bed surface is made out of. I think it's lazy and enables bad practices when it comes to 3D printing. It allows you to ignore the fact that your setup isn't perfect.
But what if I have to take the bed out?
It's fine, but you now need to absolutely reduce the bed leveling if the printer doesn't do it on its own, and find the correct offset before resuming working with that printer. Rule number three: don't use scrapers of any kind, either metal or plastic, to remove hard-to-remove prints. Models sticking to the bed aren't just a hassle. They are a symptom of an underlying failure. You have failed to set up your printing process properly. But if it already happened, I'd rather break rule number 2 and remove the bed and bend it, rather than scraping and gouging it with a metal tool. From that point forward, I would consider that bed damaged to whatever degree, and your printing setup suspect. Prints should just pop off the printing bed as it cools down. Rule number 4. If it's dead, it's dead. You can actually teach an old dog new tricks, but you can't resurrect a destroyed printing bed. If the surface is damaged, there is no amount of caressing you can do to bring it back to new. You may still be able to print on it, it may still be usable, but it will definitely diminish your 3D printing experience, and you have to accept that. You cannot expect hassle-free printing when the process is hurting. Go buy another bed and be more diligent going forward in your printing setup. In order to support my case, this is the evidence I present. This printing bed on this particular printer in this particular timeline may look like new and unused, but it's far from it. This bed offered sturdy support for hundreds and hundreds of prints, and it absolutely looks and functions like it did when it was new. I never had a bad print with it, nor encountered problems, except where I expected to meet them. Ultimately, the rules of physics cannot be broken. If the footprint of the model is ridiculously small, I will add a brim. Or when I overprinted to within millimeters of the physical edge, I also had to enable some adhesion support because at the extreme edge of the bed, heating is close to non-existent. Common sense is precious at any hour of the day. But for everyday printing, this was print it and forget it and as good as it gets. And while these models depicted here aren't exactly torture tests for a good printer, they are a healthy challenge for print bed adhesion, with lots of right angles, narrow and long lines, barely linked together, and small footprint islands. All this will have to cling dearly to the bed surface until the printing reaches the height where they all get connected together. The fact that the ender is dog slow doesn't help things either. The longer it takes to print, the higher the chances are that something will lift. However, having followed my previously mentioned rules down to a T, I'm 100% confident none of that will happen, and I can print this 1,000 times and I'll get 1,000 perfect prints back to back. That's why when I watch other people's online reviewing and talking 3D printing, it absolutely grinds my gears when I see the manifestation of their carelessness. Don't tell me you had a few adhesion problems with that shiny printer sent for review, if just a few hours in its printing life I can see with my own eyes in 4K60 that a terrible crime has been committed on that printing bed. And the worst part of it, what I'm saying here is anything but a secret. A lot of these people advise for making all the required effort for keeping the printing bed clean and undamaged. But obviously there are a lot of 3D printing preachers out there that don't follow what they preach. It's a damn shame. Remember your ABC, kids. Always be cleaning.